to welcome everyone here to the Alkmaar room in the Guildhall in Bath on this special day. And you've even brought the sunshine with you, and I'm very grateful for you for that. But of course, I give a special welcome to Vicky and Paul. And on their behalf, I'd like to welcome you all here to share with them in their wedding ceremony, because through their vows, they will be making a commitment to each other, and through your presence here, you are expressing your support for them. Firstly, some introductions. My name is Julie, and I have the honour and pleasure of conducting their ceremony. And my colleague Anne is going to do all the legal paperwork and issue the most important document, their marriage certificate. This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. And we're here this afternoon to witness and celebrate the marriage between Paul Dibley and Victoria Mary Bailey. And if anyone present knows of any lawful impediment to their marriage taking place, they should declare it now. Can I ask the important question? Who brings Vicky to be married to Paul?
I do.
Thank you. So a wee kiss, please, for Vicky. Well done. Would all the guests please be seated?
Shit.
Well, Paul and Vicky, the purpose of your marriage is that you may always love and care for and support each other through the joys and sorrows of life together. Marriage joins two people who trust in the love that they have found in each other. It is a partnership in which each can grow but still develop in their own way. And it is a statement to those around you that you have found in each other such happiness, fulfillment, and love that you wish to share your lives together. Marriage requires closeness, but occasionally a little distance. Closeness of a couple growing together, but with enough distance to allow each partner to still be their own individual self. And I know you'll be good partners because you're loving and caring, but most of all, best friends. And before you are joined together in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. And I'm sure everyone would be pleased to know that my lecture on marriage is all now fully completed. And I'm going to get on with the business of marrying you to each other. Now, the words are laid down by law, but all you have to do is repeat the words after me. No pressure, Paul. You are first, okay? So would you please repeat after me? I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Paul Dibley.
Why I, Paul Dibley.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Victoria Mary Bailey.
To Victoria Mary Bailey.
Well done. Vicky, would you please say, I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Victoria Mary Bailey.
Why I, Victoria Mary Bailey.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Paul Dibley.
To Paul Dibley.
Thank you. Well, Paul and Vicky, we all celebrate with you. We are glad to join with you in this solemnization of your marriage, to witness your vows, and to support you in your intentions for your future lives together. You have declared your freedom to marry, and now I am going to ask you to repeat the vows that will unite you as husband and wife. So step forward and place your flowers just there on the table, that's lovely. Keep a step back. And hold her hands. Turn to face each other, that's lovely. Okay. And the answer to my next question is, I do. It's a long question. Paul, do you take Vicky, whose hands you hold, to be your wife, to love and cherish her, help her and honour her, and give her understanding and comfort, whatever the future may bring?
I do.
Correct answer. And Vicky, do you take Paul to be your husband, to love and cherish, help him and honour him, and give him understanding and comfort, whatever the future may bring?
I do.
Paul, please say these vows. I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present to witness.
Here present to witness.
That I, Paul Dibley.
That I, Paul Dibley.
Do take thee, Victoria Mary Bailey.
That I do take thee, Victoria Bailey.
Mary,
sorry.
We know who we mean. To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Thank you. Vicky, would you please say, I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present to witness.
Here present to witness.
That I, Victoria Mary Bailey.
That I, Victoria Mary Bailey,
do take thee, Paul Dibley.
Do take thee, Paul Dibley.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Well, I'm going to ask you to make promises to each other. So, Paul, repeat after me. Vicky, I promise to love and cherish you.
Vicky, I promise to love and cherish you.
Comfort and care for you.
Comfort and care for you.
Honour and protect you.
Honour and protect you.
Throughout our lives together.
Throughout our lives together.
And this is my commitment to you.
And this is my commitment to you.
Would you please say, Paul, I promise to love and cherish you.
Paul, I promise to love and cherish you.
Comfort and care.
Comfort and care for you.
Honour and protect you.
Honour and protect you.
Throughout our lives together.
Throughout our lives together.
And this is my commitment to you.
And this is my commitment to you.
Now, before they exchange their wedding rings, I'm going to invite Vanessa, Vicky's mum, to perform a very lovely reading for today.
Here's to right now. You're surrounded by your loved ones and all are wishing you well as you create a brand new chapter in the story that's yours to tell. We talk about the memories you have yet to make together and the moments you've already shared to be carried with you forever. But take the time to live today. As your marriage begins, look around and soak it up, the moment we are in. For this is where the magic starts, when you both say your vows, your pledge to spend your lives as one because of the love you feel now. So yes, here's to a future that is bright and warm and clear, but more than that, here's to right now and what it means to be here.
Thank you, Vanessa, that's lovely. And now we come to the exchanging of their wedding rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the contract of marriage that you have made with each other. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning and it has no end. And it symbolizes unending and everlasting love. And they are outward signs of the lifelong promises that you have made to each other on this, your wedding day. So first of all, Paul, take the ring that you're giving to Vicky and place it to her fingertip and hold it there. And say to her, Vicky, I give you this ring.
Vicky, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a sign.
And as a sign.
Of my solemn promise.
Of my solemn promise.
To show you love, loyalty, and respect.
To show you love, loyalty, and respect.
I will be faithful.
I will be faithful.
Both in good times and bad times.
Both in good times and in bad times.
And I promise to love you.
And I promise to love you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
And now place that ring all the way onto her finger. Well done. So Vicky, take the ring and place it to Paul's fingertip. And hold it there and say to him, Paul, I give you this ring.
Paul, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a sign.
And as a sign.
Of my solemn promise.
Of my solemn promise.
To show you love, loyalty, and respect.
To show you love, loyalty, and respect.
I will be faithful.
I will be faithful.
Both in good times and bad times.
Both in good times and bad times.
And I promise to love.
And I promise to love you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Place the ring all the way on to his finger. Well done. Well, this is a new beginning for you both. May you be very happy together and may all your future hopes and dreams be fulfilled. But more importantly, may you continue to believe in each other. And may the warmth of your love enrich not only your lives, but also the lives of everyone around you. We all hope that the feelings of love that you have for each other will deepen and grow stronger throughout the years to come. And may you live fulfilled lives together. Turn to each other and take both hands together. Paul and Vicky, you have made here today all those declarations which are prescribed by law, and you have made a solemn and binding contract with each other. You have sealed that contract with the giving and the receiving of your wedding rings, and in addition, you have given to each other promises of love and commitment. And I have very much pleasure in confirming that you are now husband and wife together, and I invite you to take your first kiss as a married couple. Congratulations to you both.
Okay.
They do well. Well, traditionally, the last thing to do is to give the bride the marriage certificate. Obviously.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Face everybody. Yes. Can you take hold as well, Paul? There we go.
We'll turn around to the rules. Okay.
Mm.
And if you want them to turn around for you.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Right.
There.
Now, well, are they safe in your inside pocket, Paul?
Well, I can keep them.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah, hopefully.
They will be safe with me.
Please ask the doctor. Now, we have one special bit of music for them to lead to. And that has been chosen by William. Yes, this is a very special song.
You helped me. You helped me choose, didn't you?
So on the first day of their married life together,
it's not Jurassic Park.
Congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Goodlet.
Yay!
Wait for the music though.
Good boy. Had to be, didn't it? Had to be. Okay.
One of my favourites, this.
Ready? Okay, let's
go. Right, 2 seconds. Well, high five, mate. Thank you.